Video is about a concept that is very simple, but when I first learned it, I confused myself very badly. So the simple concept is that forming a bond releases energy, and breaking a chemical bond requires energy. So the reason that I confused myself so much about this is because in biology we learned that breaking down molecules in the body can release energy for us to live. And we had also learned that the reason certain molecules are the ones that are broken down is because they have certain high energy bonds in them. Unfortunately, that led me to think that those bonds must store energy, and so I thought that breaking those bonds would release the energy inside them. But that's not what happens. If you think about why a bond forms in the first place, it's because those two atoms are more stable after they're bonded than before. So that means that when they form the bond, they release energy, and that's why it formed. So then what really happens when we break down biological molecules like ATP or long chains of sugars? Well, a common process is hydrolysis. So a water molecule comes in, and the oxygen and the hydrogen from the water molecule form new bonds with, in the case of ATP, the phosphates and the ADP. And in the case of our carbohydrate, with the ends of the new chains, or with the sugar monomers. So those new bonds formed with the water molecule is what releases energy. So what do we mean when we say that a bond is high energy? We just mean that even though forming that bond released energy, it didn't release nearly as much energy as forming other bonds in the body, which are much more stable. This is like how negative 5 is still a higher number than negative 10. And I think a reaction that makes that kind of clear is that when you burn something, you know that that combustion reactions release energy because we see heat and light from the fire. But most compounds at room temperature aren't going to just burst into flames. At least we certainly hope not. So, in order to get the reaction to start, we need enough activation energy. That's energy that helps get a reaction started, and usually we do that by using a match, which provides heat. And part of the reason that we need activation energy is because you have to start breaking the bonds involved. So, I hope that this cleared some things up and that this video made sense. Thank you for watching.